This is not what we want, unfortunately. I just guess the cutoff level doesn't grab the microswitch from the electronic fire control unit, and that may be because there is a dual sector gear built in from G&G and someone fucked it up. We're gonna take it apart. Quick cut from this point. So, taking apart. This thing could actually use another shim. Okay, the problem seems to be that this dual sector gear does engage this cutoff a little too late or a little too early. This is actually a problem we cannot change. Because how could we? We could try to remove a little bit of material somewhere here or drop in another cutoff. But this will be experimental. And we could ruin it. And the problem is so small, it's kind of hard to identify. Because this is working. We got movement here. And that's enough to stop it. This is cycle stopping. But it's like stopping too late and yeah, let's say we shoot, shot comes, stopping here. Here it is. Okay. Stopping here. No shot at all. Shot comes. Now it's shooting. And now it's stopping. We're shooting again. Shooting. Stopping. On this point, the piston may still hang in there. And if it's stopping already, we have a problem. So, we're gonna add an ETU from PERUN to check the sensors. So we can possibly identify this. So this is PERUN upgraded ETU, ETU plus plus plus. So amazing thing. A lot smaller than the regular ETU, and it can do so goddamn many cool things like programming Both selector positions separately with firing mode, active brake, pre-cocking, binary trigger, rough reduction, and DMR mode with 0.25, 0.5, 1 second, 2 second, 3 second delay between the shots. We can do LiPo alert, and altogether this is really, really amazing. We can just add it where the regular ETU is sitting, so this is quite easy for checking. Where did I leave it? Oh. It's designed to just be drop-in for regular G&G. So that's it. If I connect a battery without a motor on it, it's in diagnostic mode. So I got this yellow light here. Okay, I'm just gonna simulate the gearbox. Well, let's do it like this. Okay. This is sitting like this. And a sector gear. Oh, wow. With some very bad point of engagement. Goes in here. And stop. Did you see the green light? The green light says there is the stopping point. With enough active brake, I would have stopped the piston on this point. Nothing more. I will shoot again. Pew! Shot. Okay, the piston goes forward. And it stopped right here. This is a little more than before. This point. And if I got the momentum from, I started from this point last time, no, last time, wait. Last time I started from this point. I start from this point, I go for momentum now. And this is fast and moving and stops right here. The active brake will not be able to stop it at this point. It's like this little, the gear has to move forward, and if it got the spinning, the power of momentum, it will release the piston and stop here. Okay. We're gonna try to go for a good angle of engagement. And yeah, we're gonna go for a good angle of engagement. I had to restart the camera again. And maybe this will solve the problem. And if it does not, this will solve the problem, because we can go for pre-cocking. And we will do this a little bit. So, pre-cocking means this thing goes for the stopping moment like this, and then it pre-cocks the gearbox like this. And it's pre-cocked a little bit. So, one shot came, the other one is just pre-cocked like this, and we go for another one. And this should fix this problem. What I do not understand is why G&G builds a dual sector gear for G&G from G&G, and it doesn't work. And so I'm gonna try another dual sector gear from SHS just to make a point. Give me a second. So this is an SHS dual sector gear, and I just guess it will work better. So okay, this was the point. Okay, now I'm going, releasing, and here. This is the point. Exactly on the release point this time. And this will be enough. The gear will just go a little further than this. So, back to base. Going. Oh, sorry. Remote stopped. Starting again. Going. Release point. This is a little bit more. Just a little bit. And this will be enough to make this work. But we will stick with the G&G one to prove it's possible. Okay. We want a proper angle of engagement. So this is bad, good. Okay, we need to remove a little bit of material from the piston. This is good. Can you see? Yeah, maybe. Okay, this is good. Everything else bad. Okay. I'm gonna add a Zorbo pad. Epis Sobo can just get this off and glue it on. I will remove all traces of lubrication, and then it should just get on fine and hold in place. That's it. Okay. We have to remove a little bit here. Gonna do this. So, if you go for a short stroking or a dual sector gear, you may remove these T's. If your spring is too weak, the piston will not be forward fast enough. But this thing goes with a 7.4 battery, and this will not be a problem. Okay, let's take a look. Okay. So this is a proper engagement. Well, and we're going to try to check the sensors again. Engagement. Going, 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 going. Tick. Better than before. Not perfect. Engagement. Going, 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 going. Tick. This point. So, like this point. This actually looks like the SHS. And I think we have to go with the ETU++, and we need to go with a little bit of pre-cocking, and then it will work like a charm. As we just did like this part, made the piston not going as far back, because we, hard to explain. We have a saw pad here, so we will not have as much room for creating energy. And we have to get a little bit more energy out of this. So I'm gonna put something on the spring guide to create a little more push. That's it. Okay, I'm gonna close it, try it out, and come back to you with feedback. Feedback? Of course it didn't work. So I just programmed a little bit of pre-cocking. This is a yellow light flashing like 3 times. You can go for, I don't know, 10 times. That's the maximum. I did 3. It worked fine. I left it. And I did a dual trigger. So if you press fire, it shoots. If you release, it shoots. When I did so, you could actually hear it, that sometimes, if I do it very, very fast, I got these double feeds, or double shots, not feeds, still in there. It's not perfect though. Next time I'm gonna short stroke this goddamn dual sector gear and go for a stronger spring, but yeah, it's fine, it works.